Hello and welcome to our show, Dying to Know. My name is George Horattas and I'm with Resurrection Cemetery. The goal of our program is to bring you topics and guests that will help you make life's important decisions, that will prepare you for the future and help you protect your loved ones. I'm very excited for today's guest. Today we have Oasis Senior Advisors and we have Vickie and Nicole. And I can't thank you enough for being here. This is such a needed service. And you have so much to share and you've helped people I know and your reputation is just exceptional in the community. So Oasis Senior Advisors, tell us what that is.
Well, thank you for having us. We're very honored to be asked to be here. Oasis Senior Advisors is a senior placement company for families that need help in finding senior living options. So typically when someone has a fall or goes to the hospital and then they transfer over to rehab for a little while, they will determine if they're safe to go home or not. And if they're not, our team steps in and helps find a safe environment for the individual. If it's independent living with services, assisted living, memory care options, or adult foster care homes that provide more one-on-one attention. So our goal is to really figure out the needs of the individual, figure out their financial situation so that they are able to afford where we're going to look, and also location preference.
I mean, without a service like that, people don't even know where to turn. And then oftentimes, I imagine, it's a panic situation.
Yeah.
Like a lot of people in my field don't pre-plan, and at times when a death occurs, it's a panic situation. Mm-hmm. So when someone falls or has a problem where they need to make a change, I imagine they call you in a panic.
They do, and typically when most of the individuals we're working with, they're already in a rehab setting and they're getting discharged from rehab. They might only get, 24, 48 hour notice sometimes, sometimes more, but then they have to quickly find a place. So our team works really, really fast. We're all local to Michigan and we know the ins and outs of the different communities and what would be an appropriate fit for that individual. So we can start the process really fast with them. I think what's really important about us for families to know is we're free service. It doesn't cost the family anything to utilize our service and our advice, and we're just there to advocate for them. And I think it's really important because they don't have anyone there to help and they don't know where to go. And they're always stressed.
Well, and every mm-hmm. community and every, what they specialize in.
Yes.
So once you know what they need, mm-hmm. you know who to call.
And there's communities on every street, it seems like these days.
Right.
It's like, how do you know which one's an appropriate fit? Or if you place mom here and then in a couple months she's, signs of dementia, is she in the right place? So we're really trying to dig deep of, when we're talking to the family, of figuring out the whole big picture, not just a short-term placement, like where is mom going to be safe or dad going to be safe for the rest of their lives.
And when you have to make a decision that quick, who's got time to shop around?
Nobody.
So what a great asset you are to the community.
Yeah.
I know a few years ago when my father's situation changed, you were the first person I called. And you said, ask me what's going on,
yeah.
And you knew exactly what to do.
Where to go. And I think it's just important that because we're local and our team, our eyes and ears are everywhere. Like when we're not with a family, we're visiting our community partners. We're in the group homes. We're everywhere that, we need to be so that we know what's safe for individuals, what a community can handle and what communities can't handle certain things. Like, for an example, a Hoyer lift. If somebody needs a Hoyer to get them in and out of bed or to the bathroom or wherever, some communities don't accept that. So we need to be able to know which ones do have that and which don't. And that's going to be something that we talk to the family about.
Mm-hmm. You've both worked in the senior world for quite a while. How many years have you been? Because I've known you quite a long time.
I've been in the industry over 10 years now.
10 years.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And Vickie?
I've been in about five, so
five.
Yeah.
Okay, and I'm 26, so when you mm-hmm. combine the amount of knowledge.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And we well, you girls have an exceptional reputation in,
Thank you.
You know, in the senior world for sure.
Yeah, I think what's important too is like our team all brings, you know, there's a team of seven of us right now, and we all bring value to the team. We have someone that specializes in dementia. We have a physical therapist on our team. Nicole brings, she's been in senior living industry for 10, 11 years, like you said. So she knows the ins and outs of every community, which is so helpful for all of us. I'm a certified senior advisor. And then we also have someone on our team that's been doing placement for over 10 years too.
Wow.
So we all bring value to our team, and we all collaborate together to make sure, you know, we're always figuring out the right options for families.
I've watched you both interact with seniors over the years, and it's just obvious your heart's in the right place.
Yes.
So
it's definitely a passion of ours, and
yeah,
very rewarding job.
Yes,
sure.
You can tell.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. As I feel about mine.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So when someone calls you, what's the process? You know, tell me a little bit about.
Yeah.
So we have an intake process where we find out location, budget, what type of assistance the person needs with their activities of daily living. You know, most of the time, if they are in the hospital or rehab, we are obviously connecting with their case manager or social worker. We keep in constant communication with not only them, but of course with family. And then we just hold their hands through the whole process, right? So we go on the tours with them and help ask questions and things like that.
Is there a follow-up after they get placed, mm-hmm, where you have that comfort that they're in the right place and things are going well?
Yeah, so we'll typically follow up with the family. We always tell them there is an adjustment period for everybody.
Sure.
Some people think it's 30 days, but I truly, and you can probably speak on this a little bit more coming from a community, but I feel like it's 60 to 90 mm-hmm days before someone really feels comfortable in their new home. Mm-hmm. So we give it some time. We'll follow up with the family usually within the first month, but then because we're touring in the community so much, it's so nice because we get to see those individuals all the time and hug them and say hi and
wow,
check on them and put eyes on them. So we do get to see them in person, and we always ask, how are they doing, you know, but typically our follow-up is with families.
Sure. That's great. So I imagine you have a lot of other resources for seniors doing,
yeah,
what you do.
Yeah. So, you know, obviously our focus with Oasis is trying to find the right fit community for the individual, but there are times where a lot of people just want to try being at home first. So when we're having this initial call with the family and trying to figure out what their needs and wants are, we're asking them questions like, so for home care, if they want to try maybe home care first, we have a ton of home care resources that we can refer to the family. We have someone on our team that can, not on our team, but works hand in hand with our team that does veterans benefits. So one of the first questions we ask a family member is, was your loved one a veteran or married to a veteran? Because aid in attendance is a great benefit for someone who qualifies. It helps pay for the community, some of the community expenses. So we will ask those questions and provide them with that type of a resource. If they're selling a home, we have a senior realtor that we work with. If they need a moving company, we've got a moving company that works just with seniors,
wow,
can help transition them from home to a smaller setting. We have a sister company that's like under the umbrella of Oasis that can help with financials. So if they have a home, let's say, and they're not ready to sell it, or they just have to do something quick, get somewhere quick, and they need the funds, they can help do a bridge loan and help with those types of resources. I'm trying to think what other ones we have. You know, we have people that are lower income that might need to get on to a Medicaid program or some type of lower income program that can help them live in a community and get some financial help. So anything we can provide to the family that when we figure out on their initial phone call, when we're talking to them, we will end the call with options of communities, but also options of resources for them. So they'll be leaving that call with so much information and with an advisor that will guide them through the whole process.
It's so impressive that it's free.
Yes.
I
yes
mean, What a great tool.
Yeah, that is, I think, one thing that we really love about our company, that they don't have to pay for our services. And it's really important, because it's another thing that people are probably stressed about. They're trying to find a community and figure out the funds to pay for that, so they don't have to worry about paying for a fee for our services. We're there just to help them through the journey.
We're going to be showing your website periodically, and I imagine people can go on the website and learn more, or we're going to have your phone number also, so people can call you.
Yeah, thank you.
You know, when it comes to different communities and residences and places that specialize in different things, what are different communities? Like, what are they like, and what are the different options at each one? Are they all the same, or?
No, they're definitely not all the same. So there's independent living, also known as like maintenance-free living. So these communities, people can live there. They don't need to necessarily need any care. They can keep their cars. They can come and go as they choose. Most of the time when we're talking about maintenance-free living, they will provide housekeeping and meals and activities, transportation to outings and things like that. They do most of the time also have a third-party provider that would assist with activities of daily living. And then there's assisted living, so that would be a licensed community for somebody who may have a higher level of care. At times, there are couples that move into assisted livings, and so they can still drive and things like that. There isn't any like stipulations, obviously, against those type of things. Also, there's secured memory care units. So these are a lot smaller of a setting, also licensed.
More controlled, more secure,
Exactly. Safe. Yeah, exactly.
So as far as independent goes, it's always intrigued me that sometimes it just makes sense to leave your home. Mm-hmm. I know it's hard. Mm-hmm. You know, people have to face their own mortality of leaving their home. But when it comes down to safety, you know, and when you think about, a lot of people get frightened when they think of independent living, how expensive. But when you think about, you know, not paying your house taxes and not, you know, paying for security system and lawn mowing and snow removal and house insurance and all these things that are rolled into one in a safe atmosphere, it just kind of makes sense at some point.
And the socialization.
That right. You're not isolated.
And
it's safe.
Right. And what happens most of the time with older adults is they start, you know, the older they get, they start becoming more anxious with all of these things that need to be done around the house, right? Like, oh, I can't vacuum any longer. Oh, I've been looking out these dirty windows for 2 years now.
I'm getting
And, you know, and like, so all of these things are just like major stressors throughout the day, right? So I was recently working with a lady who was 78 years old, and her husband had passed away 2 years ago. And she said to me, Nicole, I have been participating in these senior centers for years, and I don't want to be like a lot of these people that I see where it gets to the point where then they just can't make a decision. And then there's something unsafe that happens. And, you know, this woman, she didn't have any children or a large family or anything like that. So, and I said, you know, that is such a smart way to look at the process because nobody wants to be in like a catastrophe and then have to make a quick decision. Luckily, they have us to help them through the way, you know. But,
Are some independent living also have areas where it then you can upgrade to assisted if need be, so they can be the same building?
Yeah, we call those continuing care, like senior communities. So they can start in an independent living community, and as time progresses and maybe their care needs, you know, get higher and higher, they can go to assisted living, or if they get any signs of, you know, dementia, they can move to a memory care part or community setting. And then some of them also have like a skilled side. Mm-hmm. So if they have a fall or something happens within the community, they would, instead of having to leave, they can go right to the skilled side and get care there. So those are
such as therapy and things like that. You know, communities I've been in, I'm just so impressed with how nice they are.
I think that they're so stuck on thinking a certain way that they think it's something that it's not. But mm-hmm. really, we encourage just come in and see it. Come mm-hmm. have a meal there. Just put your eyes on it, because really, a lot of it's like a cruise ship on land, we
it
like
makes
to say
a big
sometimes.
Difference mm-hmm. going mm-hmm. in one and
it
seeing
really
what
does.
It's all about. Mm-hmm.
And that's our role, is to really just encourage them to just be open-minded and go look if mm-hmm. they're, you know, on if they're looking for more of an independent living type situation, mm-hmm. you know.
And as far as assisted living, it's still your own apartment,
yeah.
in a sense.
Even
it's
memory just, care.
It's still your own
it's
apartment.
It's still your own.
So you
it's,
have your dignity and your privacy.
Yeah, mm-hmm. yep. So that's, you can put pictures up and decorate it to make it feel, you know, like their bedroom, homey, whatever they need. Mm-hmm. You know, it's not like a hospital setting.
And I think that's what, you know, the older generation, they think about when they would go see their grandparents, and they think of this like old school ward style nursing home that has three or four people living in a room. And then they walk into one of these communities and they're like, oh, I can come and go as I choose. I can hang stuff on the walls. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like,
right.
nobody's going to tell me what to do all day long, you yeah. know? And it really makes a lot more sense once they go and check them out.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, gosh, what a great service you offer.
Yeah.
So what areas do you assist? You know, what are the Tri-County area? Or?
Yeah, so our team handles a lot of the Tri-County, Southeast Detroit. Mm-hmm. And then we have an Oasis office in the Ann Arbor area. We have two out in Grand Rapids, and we have Lansing, an Oasis Lansing that covers that surrounding area. But we are a nationwide company. So in every state, there is an Oasis, multiple Oasis offices that we can help. So I think we get, sometimes there'll be somebody that needs to move from Florida to Michigan because family's here, or I had one recently move to Chicago. So we just will start either start the process and connect them with the Oasis in that state, or vice versa. If they have a family moving to Michigan, the Oasis office connects them to us. So we all work together. And I think that's important, because it's not something that's very common with placement. It's either just local or, you know, over the phone, but we can do mm-hmm. we can do every state.
One thing I wanted to ask is, when a family, when you start to narrow down what residents or community the family needs, do you actually go there with the family too, mm-hmm. to break that ice and
yeah.
make them feel comfortable?
Mm-hmm.
Wow, that's
so
great.
So we pride ourselves on that. That is one thing we talk about it every time we're together, that we make sure we are with the family on every single tour. Now, obviously, there's some times where we might not make it here and there, but I would say, 95% of mm-hmm. the tours, we're always there. If we can't make one, we'll meet them at the next one. But
wow.
we do make sure that we are there for the whole process, from meeting them on the phone, having that initial intake, all the way up until they're moving in, and then doing follow-up with them once they're there. So we just want to be there to advocate and make sure that they can lean on us for anything. I think what I know families like, when I get off the phone with them, one thing that I always say is, you don't have to make another phone call. Like, we're here to help you. And they always say it's a weight lifted off my shoulder, because I've been on the phone all day.
Right.
And what's important about us too is, we are HIPAA compliant, so we're not gonna share contact information with the communities that they might be interested in, so they can't get bombarded by a bunch of phone calls or resources that we send them. We give them the information and they're welcome to call, but we really do all of the calling. We schedule all the tours. We go with them. We're there to protect them, because they don't need that extra added stress.
What a security
yeah.
you provide for the families. Mm-hmm. And I'm just so impressed.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Well, our viewers certainly learned a lot today. I know I did.
Yeah.
And I'm happy that I have you in my corner if
yes.
ever need be.
We're happy to help.
Mm-hmm. Gosh. Well, I can't thank you enough for being here today.
Thank you so
thank
much.
You.
And all the work that you do to take care of our seniors. Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This concludes our show for today. As usual, we will continue to bring you topics and guests that will help you make life's important decisions, that will prepare you for the future, and help you protect your loved ones. Thank you, viewers, for tuning into this episode of Dying to Know.